Namaskar to all my listeners. Thank you very much. I'm here to talk about people have problems living their life, and they have lots of sickness and lots of they have problem, cannot control their food consume, how they eat. It's called gluttony and abuse. So gluttony comes from the thing that you can eat to burn out your calories. But if you have that and you don't do exercise, it takes you to abuse. So if you are a sportman and you're a bodybuilder, it doesn't matter, you know how to control that. But food is a life. If you don't have food, you'll die of hunger. If you have food and you don't know how to control to eat food, you'll die sick and obese. So that is the problem we have. Oh, food is one thing that gives you a life. And if you don't know how to handle, it will kill you. The food is only to eat to be life, not to eat to die. That's the problem we have in the whole world right now. They're feeding the babies that the baby food, and they keep on feeding them. And nowadays you see some of the babies is only like 12, 15 months old, and they're gaining weight, too much weight, because of the hormone that parents are consuming, meat, any kind of meat, beef, chicken, lamb, goat, or whatever comes. So they are being used to grow fast, and the hormone makes them grow more fast. So if you cook your food, the heat cannot kill that hormone. So it goes to you, and through you it goes to your baby. And you are getting bigger and bigger, and then your baby is getting bigger and bigger, and you say, my healthy baby. And you say you are very healthy. If you say you are very healthy, why don't you do 10 sit-ups? If the 10 sit-ups help you out and you're not breathing very strongly and you're not breathing, you know, you're breathing normal, then you are healthy. So how are you going to tell your baby to give 10 sit-ups? He's not going to give 10 sit-ups. It's you only to control the food. Food is in this planet to eat and live a life, good life. Eat for live, don't eat for die. Don't eat, don't bring it dead. It's a poison too, food is poison. If we have a poison in a can and you give straight poison one drop to the person, he'll die. But if that poison one drop, it goes in 5 gallon bucket, it doesn't matter. So that's how we are doing things wrong with the food. And the whole world needs food. And we know some of the countries are dying hunger. Somalia and some other countries, you know, in India too. And we have so much food on our table, and we're eating so much, and we're still dying as a person who is dying hunger. We're eating and dying, and the hunger person has no food, is dying, that's why he's dying, or she is dying. So we have to control that. It doesn't matter if you have millions of dollars, you cannot eat $1 million food one time on your table, you're only going to eat as a $10 plate. You can pay $10 plate, $1 million you wanna pay, it's okay to you if you have that much money to buy one $10 plate for $1 million, it's okay. You can do that. But if you buy $1 million grocery, you cannot eat for one meal. So we have to do things, it doesn't matter your money. You think this way, how much effort the farmer put to bring that potato to your table? How much effort that farmer put to grow that carrot and lettuce and daikon to your table, broccoli and cabbage to your table. You just feel the farmer, his energy and his effort. Then you'll understand how much effort that tomato takes to come to your table. So you don't use your money. Use your common sense, how to use this product that has been provide from the produce that they're producing for us, for the consumers. The problem is this, we don't understand why we have lots of ego, because this is my money. I can buy 10 tomatoes and I eat one, I can throw 5, or I can eat 9, I can throw 9. Or if you are a, like I said, people have problem in eating, if you are obese, so you might eat that 10 tomatoes. Is that 10 tomato is good for you? It has, the medical science already discovered, it's a balanced diet. So you have to eat fraction of all those diets that keep you running. Like we have a car. Car doesn't run only with the gas. You have to put oil, you have to put brake fluid, you have to grease, and you have to check all the parts, and you have to let the computer run, and let light is on, everything. So that's how the body is too. Body has so many things to be fed, and so many things that we need to empower our body. Just like we have gas and all those things putting in our car to empower the car. So those are the things we have to understand how to use. And just see and just think. There's so many people in this world are dying hunger, and you're throwing that food in the garbage can just because it's your money. You bought it through your money. That's your thing. No, this whole world is ours. This whole food is ours, and we have to use the right way. And if you have plenty, why don't you give it to some hungry people? Instead of eating the 10 tomatoes, you keep 2 for yourself and pass on the 8 to other people. So you get blessing. And then secondly, you eating enough for your body and you're not using it wrong way. So those are the things that we have problem too. This is the big problem right now in this world. If you think, you go back 50 years back, in United States too, people were very healthy, eating good meal. Since the cereal came in United States, people start eating wrong. When the mom and grandmoms were cooking, they were eating good food. That 50 years, the farmers, and then American people too. Same thing happens to all around the world. The fast food has changed things, and people are not living their life to eat good and live good life. Instead of living a good life, they're living so painful life. Doctors are very happy about that, because they're making money through you. They're giving you these prescriptions and that prescriptions, and if this doesn't work, you come for that. That doesn't work, and this has 10 side effects, and this one is 5 side effects, and they keep on repeating on it. So put yourself to the diet that is good for you and helpful for you, and that keeps you away from the doctor, and eat right, live right, and do right. That's the human goal. And then if we are eating the animal, that's fine. So many people, I'm not a, you know, I'm a vegetarian, I'm not meat eater. But I'm not forcing you to become a vegetarian. Whatever you're practicing, it's up to you. It's you figure it out which way to go. I'm not asking you to become a vegetarian, but I have some things to say about the animals. And we say we the best of the best human being been created by Lord. Just see the human being. They go hunt the animal to feed themselves. And the animals sacrifice themselves for the human being. So figure it out, who is better now. They give their life to the human being and they can be fed. Human cannot sacrifice anything for any animals or any human being or any friends or any brother, the poorest of the poorest. They cannot sacrifice. If they sacrifice, they want them that the news supposed to be all in the newspaper or things that I did this. You cannot do anything unless the Lord lets you do. So, when you're doing all these things, you're not doing for the poorest of the poorest, or you're giving the hunger of the hungers. You're not giving the thirst of the thirsty. You're giving the person who is needed. It's not like you have so much food and you're giving a person who has nothing. That it's a blessing that we can do, that He gave us that much that we can do. So that's a big blessing too. And then, when you give it to the poorest of the poorest, whom you're giving to, you're doing things for yourself. You're doing good for yourself, getting blessed. And then secondly, you giving to Lord a glass of water, a small meal, and giving a little comfort, and He sows and thinks He can take care of that. So we don't want to do those things because it makes us to bend down or comes on our knees. Coming on your knees is the best part, but begging on your knees, Lord doesn't like that. You come on your knees in the temples, in the church, and you're begging Lord to give you things. He says, I didn't create beggars. I created best human beings. And you are the best. Everybody is important in this planet, and we have to contribute what we can do. What you are good at, you contribute this planet. What you can do, you do it for others. What you are very good at, you do something for the people are needed. That is the main goal of living. And eating too much food is no good for your body. And it's good for the doctors. And if animal can sacrifice us to give so many meals on our table, why don't we sacrifice some time and put your hand in your pocket for few needies to be fed? Giving money to the organization that they said they're doing things for the needy people and poor people. I think they're doing it only 1%. That's why they're wearing all 4 fingers have all diamond rings, and another 4 fingers, 8 fingers have diamond rings and all those things. That's the contribution that you're giving to the people is been there. And 1% goes to the poor people, that means you're getting less than 1% blessing because you use him to, you use him to take your money, and he gives only 1%, and that from 1% you get only 0.5%. Even he's ripping you off, and he's ripping off all those people, he still gets 0.5% blessing because he created something to go only a little teaspoon of the water in the mouth, and you gave the chance. You go do it yourself. Who is needed? It's right in front of you, do it. You see the man falling down and don't turn your face. You go and catch him, not to get hurt. You see a hungry man on the gas station, you buy the food and give it to him and walk away. That's the blessing. You don't want to keep records. You keep bad things record, good things you forget about it, because that's our karma. That's the human duties to do. You've got to do that. If you cannot do that, you're not counted as a human. Nowadays, animals are more better than the human being. They sacrifice their body for the human fate. And we cannot sacrifice a grain of rice for the animal. And we're calling ourselves human being. We're calling ourselves religious people. We're calling ourselves wearing gowns in Hinduism. We're doing brats, and Navratam is coming, Ram Navami is coming, all these things which we're demanding that we are doing that. No. That is for the angels. We got to love God. We are not Devi Devtas. We are human beings. We are not angels that we do things and do prayers and do service for God. No. We are human beings. We have the best part of best. We love the God. We love God. Only love. That's only the thing that we can do. That's in our power. That's why we are human beings. We don't need any service. I'm a religious, Hindu religious following guy. I do go to church only to satisfy myself. Do things, do the duties. Work is worship. Duty is God. That's what my spiritual teacher tells me. Work is worship. Duty is God. So I follow my spiritual teacher. So people have lots of problem doing all these things, and they're blaming their religion. They're running away from their religion. They're running away from the duties that has been given to them. You use all your powers to make this planet beautiful, make this planet live well. If you have a talent of electrician, you provide your neighbor electricity because you know how to do the electric work. Just do it for him. If he thinks, he thinks. He doesn't think, it doesn't matter, because you're doing it because you have a skill. And your neighbor has only skill of, he's a lawyer. So that's what he does. And you have a skill of providing light in that dark house. So you are more better than the lawyer. So we all are very important in this planet. Lord created us, everybody, not evenly. Some are big, some are small, some are thick, some are skinny. And some have lots of knowledge, some has little knowledge. But all knowledge combined together, it becomes a planet. So, whatever we have, whatever skill you have been given to Lord, you provide services to the human service. It's not services only for the temples, or only for the churches, or only for the gurdwaras, or only for the, you know, religious place. No. Service is human service. That's only the goal. And we should be very good with that, because we are human. Creator's creation, best of the best in the best, is the human being. That is. My brother Sam too, he's a very nice guy. He helps around, and he helps, you know, needy people, and he He helps disabled people. He takes care of all those things. So this all thing brings us together to become a good human being on this planet. But I'm trying to be good, I don't know. It's his decision to decide where I fall, and I don't have to worry about falling good or bad. It's our duty what we do, and we do the best what which way we can. Thank you very much. Jai Siaram.